that's gathered here today, and how fitting it is that this be the event that starts the year off in 2011, and every year. I really must commend Joe Toscano and the Commemoration Committee for having the foresight to bring such an issue like this, such an event like this before the public. A round of applause, please. Because they are truly giving recognition to Australia's First People, First Nations people. And that is what we are doing here today, commemorating the work of the freedom fighters, those who went before us, Tanaminamai and Malboy Hina, and their great story. It really is legendary. It is part of our history. It should be part of our civilization and our culture and the knowledge of it. And the fact that if you were to go down Swanson Street and survey a number of people down there, particularly those who have been through the education system, you'll realise it's not in the education system, because the Australian education system has been whitewashed regards black rights, a black presence, and the whole issue of terra nullis. You know, that thought and, attempted to whitewash the history pages of Australia's history books of an Aboriginal of Aboriginal people, our place, and indeed our identity. But thanks to these two heroes, these two men, these two warriors that stood to the point of sacrificing their own lives, that the truth may come forward, that they would stand for Aboriginal identity, Aboriginal culture, our ideologies, our beliefs, everything that we stood for. And I think that they're extremely visionary in their time, because I think that they could see after the first 60 years of occupation the threat to Aboriginal lifestyle, out of a course to our future, to our genealogy. Out of a course, we can see that what followed, if they hadn't put up the defence that they put up, there would have perhaps been even greater destruction that would have come upon Aboriginal people, particularly the acts of genocide in the attempt to abolish us, to wipe us out, and to subject us to treacherous acts by government, and later on, of course, through academia, and of course, through bringing upon us terrible, treacherous genocidal laws like the Protection Act and administered by the Protection Board, by police and welfare officers, that is still prevalent today. And as Joe said, really, has it finished? We'd have to say no. And this is, I think, what Tanaminamai and Malboy Hina could see, that the fight of resistance had to be there at that point in time, that leadership had to stand up and had to stand in the gap. Because as we know, the saying is, if we don't fight, we lose. If we don't fight, we lose. Whether we're talking about union issues, whether we're talking about civil and political rights issues, if we don't stand, if we don't fight, then we lose. And that's what it's about. And that's what we've seen in Aboriginal leadership. As the unions have stood with us in the leadership that came from the Cummeragunga Mission in the 1930s, and the leadership in the unions, of the left unions, that is, that has stood with us over an 80-year period, and all the left organisations, some of the churches and some of the groups in society have stood to defend us. And it's through our working with them, through the alliances that we have built, that has drawn great relationships. And so we've learnt that as the world's got bigger, that we've seen allies in similar leadership where they have stood to stand and to defend that which is right, and that which brings an inclusion of our identities into a huge, bigger culture. And so we can look at some examples of those. Even Che Guevara, that stood as a great leader in his time. You know, William Cooper in the 30s, that stood as a great leader in his time, with William Ferguson and Bill Owners. We can look to those that have hit the world stage as tremendous leaders, and then have captivated the minds and been a tremendous inspiration to others. And in concluding, that is exactly what Tanaminamai and Malboy Hina have been. They only need to be written into the history books, but we know that those that are digging for truth, those that are digging for right history, know of this, and I think that's part of us here today, and that is what we are celebrating. So let's not think that the job's been done, it's only just begun. And let's get into it in 2011. Thank you.